Hi, what you are looking at is a pterosaur, more commonly referred to as a pterodactyl. They are a type of flying lizard that existed from the late Jurassic to the end of the Cretaceous period, 220 to 65 million years BCE. They were not, in fact, dinosaurs, but prehistoric flying lizards. Although there are many types of pterosaurs, the most distinct and undeniably amazing feature shared by all was their ability to fly. Due to a missing link, an earlier prehistoric flying creature, the origin of the pterosaur's evolution is currently unknown. Some scientists believe they evolved from Prolactiformes, a non-flying prehistoric lizard. In the prehistoric era in which they lived, pterosaurs were literally the only species larger than insects that achieved flight. Pterosaurs flew by flapping long wings, which were made from tiny complex fibers known as actinofibers. These actinofibers allowed for precision flight. Pterosaurs also had external fibers called picenofibers. These fibers are responsible for keeping the pterosaur warm. They are very similar to the hair on mammals. Because these fibers existed on pterosaurs, it is very unlikely that they evolved into birds. Also, pterosaurs are probably the only reptile that has achieved flight. To optimize their capacity to flight, pterosaurs have evolved thin, hollow bones, similar to modern-day birds. Since evolution goal was flight for both birds and pterosaurs, convergent evolution explains the hollow bones. Another similarity to birds is the existence of air sacs in the pterosaur. These air sacs filled up with air to decrease the overall density of pterosaurs during moments of flight. In fact, pterosaurs are believed to have had highly advanced respiratory systems, which act in complete synchronicity with the flight mechanism. Birds also have this same air sac design. Wingspans for pterosaurs vary as small as 18 inches, like a bat, to wingspans larger than 40 feet, making it the largest flying creature in all of Earth's known history. Similar to all modern mammals, the hips on the egg-bearing female pterosaur were much wider than that of the males. Males had a head crest, while females did not. It is believed that the flamboyant male head crest was used to attract females, similar to the way that the male peacock uses vibrant display of feathers. Crests often varied between species, and even varied genetically within species. Yet, the purpose of the crest is always one and the same: reproduction. So that's a little bit about the pterosaur. Have a great day.